Hello, Bea here, and welcome back to Biology. Today we'll be taking a time-traveling journey through the whole history of life on Earth. It's long, it's complex, and full of more diversity than you can possibly imagine. To study geologic time, scientists break up the history of life on Earth into four eons or eras: Precambrian, Paleozoic, Mesozoic, and Cenozoic. The eras are further divided into periods. It's important to note that these eras and periods are not necessarily grouped into equal amounts of time, but are defined by the major shifts that have occurred throughout history in the types of life present. Look for these big shifts as we go through the lesson. Are we ready to time travel? Let's see how far back we can go. Yikes! This might have been a little too far. We went back 4.5 billion years. The Earth has just formed. This place is much too inhospitable to support any life. We'll need to move forward another billion years or so to see the first cells. I'll meet you there. But before we continue time traveling, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to list and describe the major eras of geologic time, and explain how the complexity and diversity of life changed over Earth's history. Ah, yes, we've time-traveled to the Precambrian Eon, 3.5 billion years ago. Earth has certainly settled down a bit in the last billion years. You may not see any life here right away, but if we were to scoop up some of this ocean water and look under a microscope, we would actually find some very primitive life forms. We start out in the Archean sub-era, where life is just getting started. The first prokaryotic cells form from clumps of organic molecules, and these will be the ancestors of today's archaea bacteria. All of the life we'll find here exists in the oceans. The simple cells that have evolved so far might dry out on land. The Earth spends another billion years in this state, being inhabited only by tiny single-celled organisms. As we enter the Proterozoic era, there is still very little oxygen in the atmosphere. Plants, which are responsible for much of our atmospheric oxygen, will eventually evolve from simpler organisms, but they don't exist quite yet. Some photosynthetic bacteria, called cyanobacteria, have begun producing oxygen, though, and eventually make enough to fill the atmosphere with about 10% of the oxygen we have today. Unfortunately for them, it's a self-defeating accomplishment, as oxygen turns out to be toxic to many early life forms. Their demise clears the way for new life forms to evolve, though, and they begin to make use of the increased oxygen in the atmosphere. Around 2 billion years ago, the first eukaryotic cells evolved, most likely as a result of one prokaryotic cell engulfing another. And it's not long after this that some of these eukaryotic cells begin clumping together to make the first multicellular organisms. It seems that bigger is definitely better in this primitive environment, and the diversity of life is about to take a giant leap forward. Near the end of the Precambrian Eon, multicellular algae can be found, and by 890 million years ago, sponges have appeared. They will become the common ancestor that give rise to all future animal species. But most life still exists only in the shallow seas. We'll have to move ahead to the next geological era to find life that can exist outside of the water. We're now 540 million years in the past, and the Paleozoic era begins with an explosion! Well, not a literal explosion, but this sudden increase in new life forms is known as the Cambrian explosion. Until now, life on Earth has consisted of mostly primitive single-celled organisms and a few emerging multicellular life forms that are still microscopic. Suddenly, conditions are just right for diversification, and countless new groups of organisms form. Looking around in the Cambrian period, we would find the first animals with hard shells, jellyfish, trilobites, and the first fishes. The ancestor to most groups of animals will evolve here, in this time period. So far, life still exists only in the oceans, but that's about to change. In the Ordovician and Silurian periods, some arthropods that have become adept at walking the sea floor will move to land, as well as a few species of plants. In the Devonian period, life continues to diversify in the ocean, and a small group of fishes will develop fins capable of doubling as legs and leave the water. We're now to the Carboniferous period. Life is continuing to expand on land. It's filled with thick, swampy forests of ferns, and their remains will eventually form underground deposits that turn into coal and other fossil fuels. The Carboniferous landscape is untamed, filled with reptilian beasts and giant dragonflies, while large creatures such as the Diplocallis roam the seas. It seems like life is off to a great start, and then suddenly it's not. A mass extinction occurs, which ends the Permian period and Paleozoic era. 95% of complex life forms go extinct. It is thought that rising global temperatures were responsible for speeding up the metabolism of marine animals, and with the oceans not able to hold enough oxygen to support them, life on Earth collapses, affecting oxygen rates on the entire planet. But not all of the species died off, and the ones that remain gave rise to a new wave of biodiversity, which started the next geologic era. Let's have a look. After the Permian extinction, one group of animals has clearly fared better than the rest. Reptiles. Any guess what well-known and often feared creatures they will give rise to? Welcome to the Mesozoic era, age of the dinosaurs. Dinosaurs will dominate this entire era, which lasts for almost 200 million years. It is divided into the Triassic, Jurassic, and Cretaceous periods. One of those names might sound a little familiar if you are into dinosaur-themed movies. During this time, hundreds of dinosaur species will both evolve and go extinct. But dinosaurs weren't the only interesting thing happening in the Mesozoic. This era also sees the first birds evolved from winged dinosaurs. Fossils of organisms, such as the Archaeopteryx, have the skull and teeth of dinosaurs, but a body structure and feathers similar to modern birds. And there's still one group of animals that you may have noticed hasn't shown up to the scene yet. They're about to make their big entrance here. Mammals! Well, the entrance itself is pretty small and unimpressive. The earliest mammals were tiny and scrappy, not too different from today's mice and rats. And plant life has taken an interesting turn as well, as we now have our first flowering trees and fruits. But all good things must come to an end. Or at least that's how it seems to go on our geologic time journey. Another mass extinction happens, which ends the Mesozoic era and wipes out the dinosaurs, as well as 80% of the other life that had evolved. This time, a rogue asteroid was to blame. It slammed into the Earth with enough force to darken the sky for years, and very few survived in the chaos that ensued. You'll read more about the asteroid and the crater it made in the lesson PDF. Just as we saw before, a mass extinction that kills off the majority of life on Earth simply makes way for new life forms to evolve and thrive. The Mesozoic was known as the age of reptiles, but as the Cenozoic era begins, 66 million years ago, it's the mammals' turn. A few small mammals had evolved by the end of the Mesozoic, and without the constant threat of dinosaurs looming, they diversified into larger and more complex forms. The Paleogene period sees a wide array of mammals emerging, such as rhinos, tapirs, camels, pigs, whales, horses, as well as the first primates. Flowering plants continue to diversify, as well as many species of grasses. However, the climate is not stable during this time period, and the rapid fluctuations cause many species to go extinct, as they are unable to adapt to the changing conditions. By the start of the Neogene era, 23 million years ago, Earth was starting to resemble something that might feel familiar to us today. Throughout history, the continents have been in constant motion, but by now, the continental arrangement would look recognizable. Most of the life we see around us here in the Neogene would look familiar as well, as most present-day animal groups have already evolved. So, the wildlife observed here would look similar to what you might see today. In Africa, one group of primates will evolve into the first hominid species, the common ancestors of today's humans. The Quaternary period, beginning 2.6 million years ago, is at first dominated by large mammals, woolly mammoths, saber-toothed cats, giant ground sloths. Most of these will go extinct soon, though, in part due to overhunting by early humans, who have become a widespread force by now. It's also a time of fluctuation between ice ages and interglacial periods, which present challenges for many of the species trying to adapt to unstable conditions. Humans and other species continue to evolve for another million years or so, and we end up right here, back in the present day. So that was a very quick tour through the history of life on Earth. It has had a long, rich history of various life forms, and the ones we see now only represent a brief snapshot of what has existed throughout time. It's important to note that while we may think of humans as being the dominant species on the planet today, our time here has been very short. We are definitely still the new kids on the scene, as the vast majority of life's history on Earth did not include us. We'll explore this idea further in the PDF. As we went through the lesson today, we explored the history of life on Earth and the four main eras it is grouped into. The Precambrian saw the first primitive single-celled life forms emerge. More complex multicellular life got underway in the Paleozoic. The Mesozoic saw the dinosaurs rise and fall. And finally, the mammals found their stride in the Cenozoic. Next time, we'll finish up our unit on evolution with a look at how we classify all of these organisms, both living and extinct, in a lesson on taxonomy. Until then, remember that biology isn't just science, it's the way of life. See you next time! Hey, hey.